Namaskar. Today I want to explain concept of diksha. Diksha. In English we say initiation. Initiation, English word, comes from to initiate. To initiate means to start something, to start a new path, new avenue of progress. That is to initiate. And then initiation. I have started something new. So in spiritual practice, there is this idea of initiation. With traditional peoples, like American Indians, Indian Indians, Africans, the tribals, there is this idea of initiation. When a boy goes through some ordeal, through some test, through some experience, maybe also psychedelic experience. And then the boy becomes a man, or a girl becomes a woman. So that kind of transition from being unaware, irresponsible, to being aware and responsible. And the borderline is initiation. So in spirituality, I find there is some similarity to that also. When you take the initiation, you kind of become, you enter into the adult life of spirituality. It's kind of like moving from school to university. In school, every teacher is after you. Oh, how are you doing? But then you go into university, nobody cares. I mean, you're adult. You care for your things. You study yourself. And of course, the teachers are there, but they read the lectures. But you have to be yourself. You have to, you know, be proactive and take the initiatives. So something similar in spiritual life. But the word, there is no proper term in English for initiation, which will properly convey the original meaning of initiation. In Tantra, Tantra means, in general, spiritual practice. Tantra, Tam means ignorance, Tra, that which liberates. Something that liberates you from ignorance. And of course, Tantra is very ancient, and there are many, many kinds of Tantra. There are dark Tantras, there are light Tantras, the dark side of the force, the bright side of the force, and many, many types. So, but in general, you can say that Tantra is a practical cult. A cult, you know, the word cult, I love this word. Cult means culture, to cultivate. So, something before the initiation is not a cult. It is an intellectual pursuit. You study something, you learn something. But then at one point you start a cult. You enter into the process of cultivation. You cultivate yourself. Harness the power of your mind. Harness the power of your spirit. That's different. So that cultivation, cult, is Tantra. Is Tantra. So, in Tantra, there is this idea of diksha, which means initiation. There is a shloka, a poetic verse explaining it. Dipa gyanam jato kuryat papakshayam tata. Tasmadikshati saprokta sarvatantrasya samata. It means the process which consists of two things. Dipagyana, the pouring of the light of knowledge. And the process which starts a process of papakshayam, kuryat papakshayam tata. Papakshayam means papa is the sin or the distortion of the mind or samskara, karma. Akshaya means waning, goes on reducing from that moment. From that moment, the sins getting extinguished from the mind. The distortions of the mind getting vanquished, being removed. So the process that starts that removal of the sins, removal of the distortions of the mind, that is papakshayam. So two things has to be there. One is dipagyana, another one is papakshayam. And that becomes di, dipani, and then kshayam, ksha, papakshayam. So di, ksha, diksha. Dipagyanam jato, kuryat papakshayam tata, tasmadikshati sapракта, sarvatantrasya samata. So that which pours the light of knowledge and then starts the requital of the samskaras, removal of the samskaras from the mind, is diksha. And all the tantras, all those diverse cults, they all agree on the necessity of the diksha. This is the diksha, and it is the fundamental point in spiritual life of the person. So let us discuss diksha first, or the dipani first. Dipani, dipagyanam, dipagyana. The light of knowledge. So what is that knowledge? What means pouring of the knowledge? Enlightenment. What is that enlightenment thing? We humans, we are spiritual. We are psychic. And we are physical. We have body, we have the mind, we have the spirit. So out of those, what is the proportion? How much of the spirit and how much of the mind and how much of the body are there? Spirit is very big, is infinite or infinite. Just think it, infinite. This universe is very big, but not infinite. This galaxy of Milky Way of ours is very big. I mean, if you measure it with houses or with tables, it's going to be very big. Very, very, very big. But it's not infinite. But your spirit is infinite. Your spirit is infinite. So, you are infinite. But the thing is that you don't know it. You don't know. You're not aware. And if a poor man lives in a very thatched hut, and in the cellar of that hut, there is a, you know, all down to the middle of the earth, there is a golden, like a mass of gold. So he lives on that hut, on top of that gold, but he never knows. He never knows that he owns so much of that gold. And in that hut there is no food, the winds are blowing. Even if he goes a little bit in the cellar and little bit mines that gold, a little, he becomes a rich man. But he never does. He never does. Because why? He doesn't know. He doesn't know, he also doesn't believe. Some people tell him, hey, why don't you go to the cellar, mine the gold? No, I wouldn't go, because I believe I'm a poor man. I believe very firmly, very strongly, I'm a physical being. I'm a materialist. So, it is true that body has the needs. When we fulfill the needs of the body, we feel, to some extent, happy. But there are also needs of the mind, and there are needs of the spirit also. The needs of the spirit. So those spiritual needs never fulfilled. Because why? Because we are never aware of those spiritual needs. Because we are never aware of our spirituality. Even though we are 100% spirit and a little tiny speck of dust is body. But we believe we are bodies and not the spirits. So that condition is called ignorance. Ignorance. You don't realize. You ignore the spiritual realm. So Tantra, Ta is ignorance. Tra, that which liberates. That which liberates from ignorance. And to start to become liberated from ignorance, you go through the process of Diksha or initiation. So Dipani is that type of knowledge. In the process, in the initiation, you have to be explained a technique how to dig that cellar, how to dive into there and dig it, how to turn the projector, how to turn the light of your awareness onto yourself. My attention, my awareness is studying the external world. Even practices such as, you know, mindfulness, being in the moment, is all about, you know, study the moment, the reality. You don't study the spirit, no, not really. But here, in the Tantric Diksha, turn your light inside. Turn the awareness inside and gaze into that infinity. Gaze there. As you gaze, you realize more and more. As you gaze, you realize more and more. You become aware. It's just like in a dark room. You come in a dark room. So many nice things are there. But it is dark, you are not aware. Your mind, your unconscious mind, is a storage of infinite wisdom, infinite knowledge, infinite inspiration, love, and ecstasy. But it is dark, and you are not aware. So what is meditation? Is to bring the light of awareness into the areas which has been hitherto unknown. They have been unknown. It is a terra incognita. It is incognita. You have not recognized it. There is no cognition. So you turn your attention within, inward. Study it. Learn it. What are you? What am I? What am I? Okay? So this is Dipani. Another thing about Dipani is we are at the mind, even the mind, not even spirit, but even the mind, it has like a three main chapters: unconscious portion of the mind, subconscious portion of the mind, and conscious portion of the mind. Conscious portion of the mind, okay, now I see, I talk, I perceive. This we all know. Subconscious is our dreaming, is our thinking, is our memory. And then unconscious. What is unconscious? Unconscious is something very interesting, deep, and fundamental. It's not your subconscious, it's not your conscious mind, which is responsible for your life. Not like that. You may think whatever you may think, it doesn't matter. What matters is what you believe. And those beliefs means really not believe intellectually, but believe what you believe. That is there your view of the world. You know, like in Star Wars, they say, oh, this is impossible, I don't believe. I say, yeah, from here is the failures. Because you don't believe. And why you don't believe? Because your unconscious mind doesn't allow you to believe. Unconscious mind, subconscious mind, is what you intellectually believe. But what you truly believe is unconscious mind. For example, person may believe that human beings are bad, you know, this world, oh baby, baby, it's a wild place, it's a wild world. The world is bad. I look and I see bad everywhere. Bad, 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 everywhere. So, of course, it is bad. And if I try to, you know, intellectually explain you, you will believe me. Because I will say, you know, this, 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 I will convince you the world is bad. Because this is my world. What I see is all bad. Why? Why? It is because of the certain tunnel in the mind through which you experience the world. Everything else gets filtered out. There is an unconscious belief. And that unconscious belief defines your existence. Or there is this, for example, another belief. There is not enough money. There is not enough resources. And then you always, in life, you always get that paradigm of yours gets proven again and again and again. Yeah, so there are many, many things that we are not aware, but they are defining things. They define our existence, our life, our behavior, everything is defined. Okay, we read some books, we think something, it's one thing. But what we believe is the main thing. So real change comes not from here, not from intellectual change. Real change comes from the change of the beliefs. And I'm not talking of the intellectual beliefs. You know, like there are religious beliefs, for example. Doesn't matter. It doesn't change anything. A little bit. There are deep beliefs. Those are beliefs of the unconscious mind. I hope you understand the point. So, my life is defined, my personality is defined by my unconscious mind, which is, by definition, is unconscious. I am unaware of what is going on inside. So, dipani is to bring the light of awareness into the unconscious area of your being. To bring into the light something which has been dark before. This is dipani. And then a competent teacher, a qualified teacher, has to explain this process to you. How you go, how you turn the attention inside, inward. And that part of initiation is called dipani. But it is not all. It is not all. One thing is to explain. Another thing is to make it work. So another part of initiation. It is also called Shakti Sampat, Shaktipat. Transmission of power. The power has to be transmitted. Spiritual power. Through initiation. And that spiritual power is like an impulse. You start an engine, a tractor. You know, the old days, there was this kind of initiation of the tractor. I was doing. It's scary, no? Because when it starts, it's like it's very powerful and it gives a lot of impact on the hands. So before the tractors, you know, the primitive age was like, and you start that. And now you start with, there is a starter in the car, electrical starter, just, and it rotates the engine, and then the engine starts to work. So similarly, when you initiate a person, you need to, through the power that you wield, you and then it's like and then the engine starts to run. And of course, it is really beyond the human power to do that, to awaken somebody spiritually. So the person who initiates has to become a conduit for the spiritual plane of existence. He has to become a conduit for spirituality. And then, by being conduit, he creates an impact. So that impact initiates the process of Papakshayam. Papakshayam, now I will explain. Papa means sin. Or Papa means also distortion of the mind, samskara. When you make an action, that action distorts your mind. If you do something externally, there are two parts of action. For example, I want to change, I want to move this leaf from this position to this position. So to do that movement, I have to first do it in the mind. I have to first change the mind. Otherwise, if then the mind is not changed, then there will be no movement, okay? So first, every action is first goes the mental action. And that mental action leaves the footprint in the mind. So that type of footprint is called samskara. You take a piece of metal, for example, like a sheet, like a paper, but out of metal. So, and then you hit it. You take that tool, you know, like a nail, and then you hit it. So there will be some kind of distortion in the metal. There will be imprint in the metal. To remove that imprint, you have to turn the metal another side and then hit it from another side with the same intensity. And then it will be even after that. So similarly, there are the actions that we've done in the past. They have created so many distortions. And those distortions, they create in the unconscious mind. They create the distortions of our belief systems. We cannot see the reality clearly. We do not understand reality for what it is. Our mind distorts the reality. Our mind produces our own reality. So, Kuryat Papakshayam Tata. The process of Papakshayam, the removal of those distortions, starts in the initiation. Through the spiritual power transmitted to you during initiation, you start to remove those distortions. And then, just like a carpet, no? The old ways, you take out the dust out of the carpet. You just hit the carpet like this. No, not with the vacuum cleaner, but with a stick. And then the dust come out. Have you done that? So similarly, you start meditating, and you take out the dust of the mind, all those distortions. So to help removing those distortions, the external situations arise in your life. Some situations, you lost something, you gained something, something good, something bad. Through all those things, the distortions are removed. Mostly it is removed through your meditation. But some portion of those distortions, they don't go until you experience something externally. So the process of burning of karma starts with the process of initiation. Your life starts to speed up. It goes faster and faster and faster. So the speeding up of your life is very good, because then you are removing those deep unconscious programs which were installed in you, and you really change as personality. Because by intellectual changing, you are not changing. You are really changing by changing on the on the unconscious level of the mind. So that is papakshayam. So diksha means two things: dipani, papakshayam. All tantras agree on that. And then, if the competent teacher is there, he can do a diksha. He can transmit the power, and he can give you the light of knowledge, the light of awareness. And then it's like a seed, you know, initiation, you put the seed, and then from that seed, the big tree will grow. It's the seed of awareness. You start to become a little bit aware of the infinite reality. And then slowly, slowly, that little awareness grows into infinite awareness. And then once you realize, once you understand your spirituality, you can be happy because your spiritual needs are taken care for. So, with initiation, in life comes divine love. It's spiritual. It's not physical. Spiritual. Ecstasy. Wisdom. Yeah, and many beautiful things. So this is about diksha, explanation of concepts. If you want, I can continue on this topic. It's a big topic. I can speak more. There are many kinds of diksha. Vedic diksha, Vaidiki diksha, Tantriki diksha. And I can go on explaining that. If there is an interest in the topic, please write in the comments what you think. I hope this... I'm trying to really draw your attention to something that you have not been paying attention to. It is interesting, really. It's really, really interesting how we are determined by the layers of the mind. We are completely have no idea of. You know, now they do experimentations with the brain, and they realize that the brain takes decision maybe 5 seconds before you realize the decision. Imagine that. And you think that it is my decision. Yes, it is yours, but not on the conscious level. It is deeply unconscious. From deep layers of your mind it comes. And then if you work on those layers, on the deep layers, then the real change comes in your life. Thank you very much. Namaskar. Будешь это видео отсылать?